It's a tremendous honour to be nominated for the Miles Franklin Shortlist in 2022.
It's always nice to feel like you're being recognised by the literary firmament, but it also feels really special to be on a long list and a short list with this great breadth and depth of storytelling range. I feel very lucky to be among them. Bodies of Light tells the story of a woman named Maggie from the 1970s through to the present day, who grows up in residential and out-of-home care in outer suburban Melbourne, follows her life through to the present day where she's living in Burlington, Vermont. It's a story of systemic failures in child welfare, but it's also the story of reinvention in the face of multiple traumatic events.
Menzies Avenue, Dandenong, 1979. When they came for me, Dad went ballistic. First, it was just one welfare officer, a woman, the three of us standing in the lounge room. And when Dad got loud, she put her body between his and mine. And his arms reached for me, and he became a machine, propeller limbs and metallic fury and a blazing noise, sending things spinning around him, lamp, ashtray, long neck, TV, water glass. And Dad told me to get in the bathroom, and I shut the door and climbed into the tub and waited. And eventually I knew the welfare was gone because Dad was yelling at the front of the house, and then I heard a car drive off, and I thought that was that.
I've always been interested but also horrified by the way that the state fails our most vulnerable people, especially young people and children. This book felt like a way to explore that and what it's meant historically as well, you know, throughout the sort of mid to late 20th century. I have a small studio that is very cold and very drafty, but it is a room of one's own, and I go there to write as much as I can. I spend a really long time, sometimes years, doing research, and for this book I spent quite a lot of time in archival or kind of forensic material. I used to say I was a slow writer, but I've realised that actually when I sit down to do the writing, it comes out pretty quickly and I think effortlessly. But that's probably only because I've spent so long with all of this information kicking around in my head.